السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, inshallah we will speak about some of the ayat and some of the ahadith wherein Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us about salah in congregation, where he ordered the men to read salah in congregation, and how salah in jama'ah, salah in congregation, is compulsory upon the men. As for the women, salah in congregation is not compulsory upon them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in a hadith which is in Sahih al-Bukhari, لا تمنعوا إماء الله مساجد الله. Do not prevent the women folk, those who are the worshippers of Allah, from the women, do not prevent them from coming to the masjid. But they should know, وَبُيُوتُهُنَّ خَيْرٌ لَهُنَّ, their houses are better for them. In other words, for a woman, it is better for her to read salah at home. But if she wants to come to the masjid, and as long as she is dressed properly, following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she asks to come to the masjid, then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, don't prevent them from coming. But they should know their houses are better for them. As for the men, Allah jalla wa ala says in the Quran, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَارْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ. In the beginning of this ayah, Allah jalla wa ala says, establish your salah. He's ordering us to read our salah and to give out zakah. Then he said, وَارْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ. Make ruku' with those who are making ruku'. In other words, read salah with those who are reading salah. Meaning, read your salah in jama'ah. Read your salah in congregation. One day a blind man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He could not see. He said, O Messenger of Allah, I do not have anybody to bring me to the masjid, and I am blind. So can you excuse me, or can you find for me an excuse so that I can read salah in my house? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, okay. But before this man was about to leave, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called him. Imagine this man who is blind. He cannot see. He may lose his way going to the masjid. He may walk into certain obstacles on the way to the masjid. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, do you hear the call for prayer? He said, yes. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَأَجِبْ, which means then you should come for salah in congregation. In other words, salah in congregation upon you is compulsory. What about those who can see, those who are fit, those who do not need assistance to come to the masjid? Here Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling a blind man that he should read his salah. He has to read his salah in congregation. It is recorded in the hadith of Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, which is recorded in Sahih Muslim. He says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من سره أن يلقى الله غدا مسلما فليحافظ على هؤلاء الصلوات حيث ينادى بهن, أي في المساجد. The one who wants to be happy when he meets Allah jalla wa ala, and he wants to meet Allah jalla wa ala as a Muslim, he should protect these salawat from where their call is given from. In other words, in the masajid. He should read his salah in congregation. Thereafter he said, verily, Allah jalla wa ala gave Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the best of ways. And salatul jama'ah is from the way, from the practice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَوْ أَنَّكُمْ صَلَّيْتُمْ فِي بُيُوتِكُمْ كَمَا يُصَلِّي هَذَا الْمُتَخَلِّفْ فِي بَيْتِهِ لَتَرَكْتُمْ سُنَّةَ نَبِيِّكُمْ وَلَوْ تَرَكْتُمْ سُنَّةَ نَبِيِّكُمْ لَضَلَلْتُمْ. If you had to read salah in your houses, in the same way this mutakhallif reads, this person who does not attend his salah in congregation, you would have left the sunnah of your Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if you leave his sunnah, you will be misguided. Thereafter he said, speaking about some of the rewards and some of the virtues of reading salah in jama'ah, he says, there is no man, وَمَا مِنْ رَجُلٍ يَتَطَهَّرُ فَيُحْسِنُ الطُّهُورِ. There is no man who makes wudu and he perfects his wudu at home, then he intends to come to the masjid. He is coming solely for the sake of Allah jalla wa ala. He is not coming to meet anybody. He is not coming to discuss some worldly matter. He is coming solely for the sake of Allah Jalla wa Ala. He says, for every step he takes to the masjid, a good deed will be written for him. And he will be raised a level. And a bad deed will be wiped away. Thereafter he said, at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we as the companions, وَمَا يَتَخَلَّفُ عَنْهَا, speaking about salah in congregation, the only people who used to miss salah in congregation were those who were known hypocrites. إِلَّا مُنَافِقْ مَعْلُومٌ نِفَاقٌ. Then he said, as for the believers, they used to come even if it meant leaning on the shoulders of two people. Even if they could not walk, they would seek assistance and they would be brought to the masjid. Here in this hadith we find the great rewards of reading salah in jama'ah and how salah in congregation was from the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he read Salatul Fajr with the companions and he turned around and he asked, where is so and so? This was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He had mercy towards his companions. He would ask about them. Maybe somebody needed something or somebody was ill so they could visit them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would ask about them. One day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, he said, have you seen so and so? They said, no, O Messenger of Allah. Is so and so present here? They said, no, O Messenger of Allah. Thereafter Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, verily these two salawat, Salatul Fajr and Salatul Isha, they are the heaviest on the munafiqeen, on the hypocrites. And if they knew what was in these two salawat, when it comes to goodness, when it comes to reward, they would have come even if it meant coming crawling. Even if it meant coming crawling. This was the advice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We should remember there is nothing to be proud of if we boast that we can run very fast. Or in the gym we can bench so many kgs. Or we have extremely good bodies. That is of no good and there is no point boasting about it if people in wheelchairs, people who are sick, people who cannot even walk, they need assistance to come to the masjid. If they are in the masjid and you are not, there is nothing to be proud of. What good is all this physique, all this strength? When people who are sick, people who need assistance, they are in the first saf. And they are at every single salah. Imam Malik has recorded in Muwatta that Umar radiallahu anhu, when he read the salah one day, he did not find Sulaiman ibn Abi Hathma. So after salah, after the Fajr salah, he was walking to the marketplace. And the house of Sulaiman happened to be between Masjid al-Nabawi and the marketplace. So Umar radiallahu anhu, when he was walking past, he saw Sulaiman's mother. So he said, where was Sulaiman? So she said, Sulaiman, he was delayed because he overslept a little bit. Why? He was reading voluntary salah at night. In other words, he read voluntary salah at night, so he was a bit tired. So he overslept a little bit and he was unable to come to the masjid in order to read salah in congregation. Umar radiallahu anhu replied, for me to witness salah in jama'ah, salah in congregation, is more beloved than me reading salah the whole night. And from this we learn the fiqh, the understanding of Umar radiallahu anhu when it came to the deen. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in a hadith which is in Sahih Muslim, the one who reads Salatul Isha in congregation, it is as though he has stood half the night in prayer. As for the one who comes back and reads his Salatul Fajr in congregation, it is as though he has stood a full night in prayer. When we look at this hadith, we find that Umar radiallahu anhu is reprimanding a person who missed Salah in congregation due to him being involved in a voluntary act of worship. What about those who miss Salatul Fajr in jama'ah because they stayed up on haram? Or those who they didn't
do anything haram. They did something that was neither haram nor halal, but it caused them to miss salah in congregation. Here Umar radiallahu anhu is telling a man who was reading salah, voluntary salah. Umar radiallahu anhu is reprimanding him. When it comes to Salatul Fajr especially, we find that sometimes we feel it's very difficult to get up. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us why in the hadith, which is recorded in Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. He says, when a person goes to sleep, shaitan comes and ties 3 knots by his head. And he says, sleep. You have a very long night ahead of you. Sleep. Thereafter, if this person had to wake up on the dhikr of Allah jalla wa ala, he remembers Allah jalla wa ala, the first knot is untied. Then if he had to go and make wudu, the second knot is untied. And if he had to read his Salatul Fajr, the third knot is untied. Thereafter he becomes active. As for the one who does not get up on the dhikr of Allah jalla wa ala, he does not make wudu, he does not read his Salatul Fajr, you find that he has a difficult day. He wakes up very lazy. And ask those who come to Salatul Fajr, sometimes you will be very tired just before the Salah, but after that Salah is finished, you become active. You find strength and energy. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is recorded in Sahih al-Bukhari, that after Salatul Fajr, he used to turn around and look at the companions, and he would ask them sometimes if anybody had seen a dream, so he could interpret this dream. One day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked the companions, has anybody seen a dream? So none of them had seen a dream. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, as for me, I will inform you what I saw. In a long hadith, one of the things he mentions, he says, and I was taken and shown a man who was lying down. And there was another man who had a boulder in his hand, a rock in his hand. And he was throwing it at the head of the man who was lying down. And this man's skull would shatter, it would break, and the rock would roll to the side. So he would go again to get the rock. As soon as he got this rock, the man's head would return back to normal. And he would carry on smashing this man's skull. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, what is this? They said, carry on, we will inform you later. At the end of the hadith, they informed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As for the person who you saw, his head being smashed, he is the one who, when it came to the Quran, when it came to taking the Quran, he took it but he rejected it. In other words, he rejected the Quran. And when it came to compulsory salah, he was sleeping. He missed his salah due to sleep. In other words, he was lazy. Look at the punishment for the one who misses his salah because he is sleeping. It is recorded that at the time of Umar radiallahu anhu, there was a man who had lost his eyesight. So Umar radiallahu anhu went to visit him. And the first thing he told him, he said, don't miss Salatul Jumu'ah and don't miss Salah in the Masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this man was close on to 100 years. We should ask ourselves, in these ahadith, we find Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advising those who were blind, telling them to come to the masjid. And we find the Sahaba radiallahu anhum following the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, telling the people, encouraging them when it comes to reading salah in congregation. As Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, salah in congregation is from the sunnah of your Nabi. It is from the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if you had to leave the sunnah, you will be misguided. We should ponder over the great reward mentioned for the one who reads salah in jama'ah. The one who comes to the masjid, the house of Allah jalla wa ala, where the call is given, hayya ala salah, come to salah, hayya ala al-falah, come to falah, come to success. We should ask ourselves, how can we allow ourselves to miss the great reward promised? As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, one day he told the companions, he said, should I not inform you about something? that wipes away sin, where Allah Jalla wa Ala forgives your sin. So they said, yes, O Messenger of Allah. He said, إِسْبَاغُ الْوُضُوءِ عَلَى الْمَكَارِهِ, making wudu and perfecting it, especially at difficult times. In other words, for example, you wake up in the morning and it's cold, but you force yourself to make wudu. Then he said, وَكَثْرَةُ الْخُطَى إِلَى الْمَسَاجِدِ, and taking many steps to the masjid. And as we mentioned, for every step you take, a good deed is written for you. A bad deed is wiped away. You are raised a level. That is why the ulama mention in the books of fiqh that when one is walking to the masjid, he should take, or he should make his steps a bit smaller, so that he may get more steps and get more reward in turn. Thereafter, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَانْتِظَارُ الصَّلَاةِ بَعْدَ الصَّلَاةِ فَذَلِكُمُ الرِّبَاطِ فَذَلِكُمُ الرِّبَاطِ, and waiting for salah, meaning when you sit and you have read a salah, there is nothing keeping you in the masjid except that you are waiting for the next salah. In another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the one who comes to the masjid and there is nothing keeping him waiting except salah, whilst he is waiting, the angels, they make dua for him. They ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to forgive him. They ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to have mercy on him. As for the one who sleeps when it comes to salah in congregation, he should ask himself and he should ponder, how is it that the Muslimin, the rest of the Muslim, they are in the house of Allah Jalla wa Ala. They are asking Allah Jalla wa Ala. They are making dua to Allah Jalla wa Ala. Allah Jalla wa Ala is forgiving their sins. Allah Jalla wa Ala grants them what they are asking for. Allah Jalla wa Ala, as we mentioned, when it comes to Salatul Fajr, the one who reads Salatul Fajr, فَهُوَ فِي ذِمَّةِ اللَّهِ, he is under the protection of Allah Jalla wa Ala. So many great rewards. And if you had to look at the people in the masjid, you would find that a lot of them are sickly. A lot of them have to read on chairs. A lot of them actually have to come with other people to the masjid because they need assistance. So we should ask ourselves, as young people who are healthy, who do not need assistance, who have motor vehicles, who can hear the call to prayer, they hear the adhan, the masajid are close. We should ask ourselves, as a Muslim, how can I prevent myself from this great goodness? When it comes to shaitan, he has many ways and he uses many tactics. His main objective, firstly, is to make you leave your salah. If he is not successful and he finds you reading salah in jama'ah, he tries another tactic. He comes to you and he'll say, your salah in jama'ah, or he whispers to you that you do not have to read salah in jama'ah. After that, when you stop reading salah in jama'ah, when it comes to the times of salah, you find that he tries to make you read salah at the end of time. So in dhuhr, there's 2 hours left, he'll tell you, read in the last 10 minutes. After that, you find yourself reading your salah when the time has expired. After that, you find yourself leaving salah altogether. As for the one who still comes to the masjid, beware, shaitan plots against you. He will tell you, the salah in congregation will start after 20 minutes. So come just a few minutes before. He tries to delay you so you don't get the goodness of coming early to the masjid. You don't get the goodness of the angels making dua for you when you are waiting for salah. We ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to make us from those who read salah solely for His sake. We ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to make us from those who read salah in congregation. We ask Him to forgive us, to forgive our parents, to forgive our mashayikh, to forgive all the Muslimin, those who are alive and those who have passed away. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala abdika wa rasulika nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.